Biodiversity Conservation Foundation is an NGO based in Tamil Nadu with the vision to visualize a society for promoting and assisting in healthy coexistence of human and wildlife and ultimately ensuring conservation of biodiversity. Strategic implementation of this mission drove us to handle research and reaching stakeholders in a very synchronized manner. Our research extends from ants to elephants and exploring effective management practices in the perspective of biodiversity conservation. With our wide research team, we were able to work from Nagapattinam to Valley of Flowers, stretching across different landscapes and different people with varied dependency on the ecosystem. In a nutshell, we connect nature with people and people with nature. So let's get connected today also in the virtual platform to experience nature in an enhanced dimension.
Thank you, sir.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Good evening, everybody. So this is my 30th webinar during lockdown. So let me thank this BCF India, Biodiversity Conservation Foundation India, for organizing this webinar. Okay, so let me thank the scientists, conservation scientists, and then BCF, Tamil Nadu Forest Department, Dr. Kumaragugu. Thank you so much, sir, for giving this opportunity. And then let me remember the founder of this BCF India, Mr. Thiru Arumugam. So because of him, almost a decade we are having this BCF India. So, okay, fantastic. So while looking into this Dr. Arumugam's, Dr. Kumaragugu's profile, I am wondering, recently he is having this monograph on bird survey. In May month itself, he is having 3 publications. I saw his profile in ResearchGate. I was shocked and stunned and surprised. Such a eminent, and he is calling me as eminent, but I am not sure. We people are just lab people, but he is a mobile people. I think right now from the board, he has given this intro. So excellent publications he is having, and especially 3 publications in this May 2020. And while looking further of his profile, his career profile, it's a very diverse, dynamic, energetic Sarah Ryan Hills, along with I think Father John Brito from Trichy, and then Olive Ridley's conservation, and then Mudumalai Tigers. So is it clear, no? The audible and video and all clear, no?
It's clear, Dr. Thank you.
So I can see this as a researcher, before starting, I used to read the fine details of the foundation or university or colleges, whoever inviting me. Then I felt, a fantastic profile this founder is having. Diverse profile, especially he's the real conservation scientist, I can say that. Hope in future we will have some good collaborations with foreign universities, because after this COVID I am planning to go to Stockholm University, Sweden, an ecology department, so that we can have something collaborative. So with this positive note, okay, and also this is major important thing, he is in this International Whaling Commission also. So let me appreciate you, sir, for your excellent and dynamic profile you are having.
Thank you, doctor. It's all blessed because whoever ready to dissolve towards preserving nature and natural resources, definitely nature won't allow to without anything. So this is a credential, whatever the credential. So because of my work and hard work only never fails. I believe always that one.
Thank you,
sir. For detailing this much of inquiry is made about my argument.
Yes. This is my cordial involvement in your BCF India.
Thanks.
So while seeing this profile, I understood this biodiversity conservation is not a single disciplinary, it's a multidisciplinary and interdisciplinary, cross-disciplinary and transdisciplinary. Almost all kinds are combined together and coming into biodiversity conservation. Fantastic. So let me thank another man, Professor Dr. Karthikeyan. So I visited almost 4 years ago to Coimbatore IFGTP, and he only recommended me to Dr. Kumaraguru and 2KK. Kumaraguru and Karthikeyan combinedly, they invited me for this webinar. Okay, then I studied this India BCF Foundation. Then I entered into these activities and then I collected the information. Really surprised, because highly active foundation, I can say that as an expert or as a plant molecular biology scientist, I'm saying that it's really active, doing especially besides the common fantastic remembrance, say for example World Tiger Day and other things, and they conducted so many things, walking fish and then bird survey, migratory birds, and so much of activities. So during lockdown, they started this Google Meet. Then I counted how many in June 4 webinars, because I know few top colleges in Chennai, they booked me almost 1 month ago. Till now, they are not able to finalize. So that means within short time, they had so much of webinar. And while introducing, he said BCF webinars. It's a fantastic term I liked very much. In the month of June, 4 webinars. Whereas in July, they increased almost near double, 7 webinars in July, and 2 more in the pipeline. I think in the coming days, you are having this. Fantastic. So while presenting in IFGTP 4 years ago, this is my nature. I used to view without any notes. I used to talk with the remote in my hand. So face-to-face discussion. And before going to Turkey, Istanbul, almost 57 motivational lectures I have given to colleges and universities. All the time I used to walk and talk. While I am saying is, today is a unique situation. Sitting and seeing the laptop, I am talking. So it's a total virtual. Okay. So that means, so globally for elite people, for intelligent people or scholars, mask only for the face, not for our knowledge. So with this positive note, I'm entering into my title, Biotechnology and Biodiversity Conservation. I have seen so many students, they registered in this webinar. So mostly I am motivating the students. Two keywords in this title. And this title also Dr. Kumaraguru only gave to me. I gave other titles, but he selected this intelligent title. So that means he is fine-tuning the resource persons also. So with this past, you know, I'm telling two keywords, biotechnology. And then this part, you know, all very well, bioconservation, biodiversity conservation, BT and BC. Then I studied all the titles, 11 webinars so far they conducted. So all the titles were more specific, so based on the resource persons' expertise. But only in my case, the title is oceanic title, as Dr. Kumaraguru while introducing, he also mentioned that sophisticated, advanced and oceanic titles in both domains, so much of studies. Okay. And in my case, it's two domains, two oceans, they are mingling together, biotechnology, that itself is a very big ocean, biodiversity conservation is another domain. So I will try to present as a molecular biologist within this given time. Fantastic. And molecular biologist. And this webinar, all my webinar, I'm going to give only seed information, and you have to develop further from this seed information. So that means I am going to just igniting the minds of BCF, smart minds of BCF regarding the biotechnology and biodiversity conservation during this Google Meet. And probably everybody knows that there is a book publishers, Springer Verlag, Springer Company. And almost all the disciplines, they are publishing a papers. And I found that recently they published a book title itself, the exactly similar to this webinar title, Biotechnology and Biodiversity. Okay, fantastic. And this is the series of books, Sustainable Development and Biodiversity. Maybe if possible, your BCF can purchase this book for further developments. And while looking into this cost of this book, I thought of buying, then I thought it's too much, it's expensive, 12,000, something like that. So that means it's chapters, excellent chapters. One chapter, using transgenic plants for biodiversity conservation in Indian context. I think it's a more debateful one, but it's really, I can suggest this book for BCF. And biotechnology, no need to tell, it's a vast technology. It starts from small gene into molecular cloning. And you should note that the biotechnics are different, biotechnology is different. Say for example, using few examples from biodiversity, I'm telling this. Say for example, the camera traps nowadays, people are using all over the world to count or census tiger or elephants. Having the GPS track or this camera track is one of the techniques. It's not technology, it's a technique. Similarly, X-ray micro CT scans. So recently they conducted in Calcutta, BSI, Botanical Society of India, with butterflies. So they found that these predators become protectors, especially these caterpillars, they are interact with the ants and it helps the pollination and everything. So this micro CT scan is also a biotechnique. Okay. Then probably everybody knows that recently drones, they used to control these swarms of locusts in Jaipur and other places. So this is also a biotechnique. Biotechnology is different. That is in situ. I will discuss later part of my seminar. Fantastic. So simply saying, biotechnology means genetic resources or genetic materials. So in a brilliant way, I looked into invitation. I saw that on both sides, they put these DNA molecules, double-stranded DNA molecules. So that means biotechnology, the start materials or template is genetic material. So in those days, it's a double-stranded. Right now, it's a recent transcriptomic and genomics. Single-stranded RNA transcript level, fantastic. So today we are going to discuss this aspect. And for students and scholars, all people know that this website, it's a library genesis common website. You can download any books you can download it. So this morning I checked how many books are available in biodiversity using this keyword biodiversity. So you will not believe that more than 628 books are available. Just imagine. That's why I said this topic is an oceanic topic. 628 books. Even if you read 28 books, you will be filled with so much of knowledge. 628 books. For students, I am suggesting you don't need to read all the books. At least give you a glance on few books. So it will be useful for your career development. You can design your career study, higher studies, fantastic. So coming to the biodiversity, you can study this biodiversity at various levels, I can say. Or otherwise we can say like that, regarding this biodiversity, extensive studies have done at various levels. One is global levels, continental levels, national levels, ecosystem levels, organisms levels, economic levels, and health sector levels. Seven levels I classified. I myself categorized it. But if you go deeper, there are so much of levels. But these seven major levels, conservation scientists must know that. In each level, I am going to say a few words about it. So coming to the global levels, So global level starts from what is biodiversity. I think there is no need of definition for this biodiversity. So diverse organisms in biological category is called as biodiversity. Only in science there is no need of going for dictionary. The word itself will carry the meaning. So this biodiversity, and then people started studying biology of the biodiversity. That is the start of this global biodiversity perspectives. And then in biodiversity, global biodiversity, you have encyclopedia of biodiversity. There are 5 volumes. You can download this, any volumes, free of cost in library Genesis. Okay. And then in India, Professor P.C. Trivedi, he has written a book on global biodiversity status and conservation. So that means the status and then the resources, what are the resources at global biodiversity level, have been studied very well, extensively and intensively. And then functional roles of biodiversity at global perspectives also studied, and it was in a book. And United Nations Environmental Program, they are also having 4 outlooks books, 4 volumes, global biodiversity, outlook number 1, 2, and then 3 and 4. And this 4th volume, it has strategic plan for biodiversity for the 10 years to 2011 to 2020. If you have time, just to give you a glance on this outlook book, you will understand the global biodiversity. Coming to the continental, and we know that there are 7 continents, and there are so much of studies, and then a lot of books are available for continental level, and this book is about Europe continent, and then this one, Antarctica. And in Antarctica biodiversity, special order level or biota level, fungi Antarctica biodiversity, and then biotechnological applications. And in Nature, the science, the magazine Nature, whose impact factor is more than 40. Okay, so in 2007 it came up with a entire volume about Antarctic biodiversity. Okay, so if you have time, just to give you a glance of all these abstracts, it's a really fantastic volume, I can say that. And then not only this, and America, North America, Central America and South America, and within South America, Atlantic forest and South America forest biodiversity, mycorrhizal biodiversity. So that means they studied very much, very well and extensively. And continental West African biodiversity, East African biodiversity. So coming to Asia, Southeast Asia, so much of biodiversity books, Asia and the Pacific Ocean. And then specifically the birds of Southeast Asia, Central Asia. I think our BCF is more active in birds survey. And then Australia's biodiversity and the compositional changes and the climate change, especially global warming and this fires, I think everybody knows that. A lot of fires recently in Australia. And then European soil biodiversity. While coming to the national biodiversity, there are a few selected nations, they have a lot of studies. Costa Rica, they have biodiversity conservation plans and programs specific, and especially Sweden, because I was in Sweden for more than 12 years, Stockholm University, Sweden. Biodiversity in Sweden and Britain, especially the birds common to Northwest Europe and Himalayas, so including many countries, Pakistan, India, Bangladesh, Bhutan, Nepal, Himalayas. Biodiversity in the changing world. So in Andhra Pradesh, Anandapur, Sri Krishna Deva University Professor Pullaya. Okay. So it's a really dynamic person like our Kumara Guru, I can say. So 8 volumes he published regarding biodiversity in India. At least the 8th volume tried to give you a glance. It's 4, 5, 6. It's really, really high potential personality he is. And many books, single author books. And then volume 7 and 8. So this is regarding the national. Coming to the biodiversity of ecosystem, ecosystem biodiversity, because biodiversity is functional, the functionality of the biodiversity is based on the ecosystems mainly. So for our convenience, we are dividing biodiversity and we are studying few organisms, but it includes, they are integrated inside these ecosystems. So at ecosystem level, they studied a lot, marine ecosystem, and then forest ecosystem, especially diversity in functions and how to conserve this forest biodiversity. And in forestry, agroforestry biodiversity conservation, especially in tropical landscapes. And then agricultural ecosystem, mountain ecosystem biodiversity, drylands biodiversity, wetland biodiversity. So these are the areas they have studied very well and came up with their volumes of books. And polar ecosystem, it's very frozen, what are the microbes are present. And from these microbes, especially polar regions and then hot desert regions, in biotechnology, they are isolating an enzyme called DNA polymerases, which are involved in this PCR, RT-PCR, especially for this COVID check RT-PCR. A particular enzyme is used, which are thermal tolerant, so desert and polar ecosystems. And underwater coral reef biodiversity, which is the most important hotspots. Later part, I will discuss how the global warming is affecting this coral reefs ecosystems. So they're coming to the organisms. Many, many people, they focused on a particular species and which are major units of the biodiversity. So they started focusing on a particular organisms level biodiversity, especially the protists. It's an ancestor of eukaryotic organisms. So protist diversity and geographical distribution, well studied one. And fungal biodiversity, and how to monitor this biodiversities by staining methods. And phytoplanktons. Phytoplanktons are the plant-like organisms which are present in the water and which involves in the productivity of this marine ecosystem or water ecosystem, phytoplanktons, and their diversity and yeast, mainly yeast biodiversity. And then in organisms, so they started studying the insect conservation and insect biodiversity. And ants, which are involved in these agricultural things, and their monitoring methodology, standard methodology, they study very well. Birds, biodiversity. And then large carnivores, biodiversity, and their conservations. So these are all the things, the areas where these biodiversity conservation scientists, they worked on. They spent huge years, they came up with these monographs and books, reptile biodiversity. And then this is most important, the fish parasites. What are the parasites diversity which are affecting the marine production, productivity of the marine things? And then management of this agro ecosystem. So these are all they studied, and not only this natural thing, and then introduced to plants. When especially we in India, we have monoculture system. Okay, suddenly we are always following extremes. Suddenly we used to on some leaders, political leaders' birthdays, 70 lakhs, 60 lakhs trees, saplings, planting. So what are the diversity of ecology and then their influences on this biodiversity composition by these introduced plants, as well as the enclosed sea systems, marine habitats. And then combinational, so how the microbes are changing the biodiversity, plant biodiversity in this particular area. So that is symbiotic relationship or symbiotic influences on biodiversity composition. And finally, the human race, the human biodiversity. Understand? So it's a very, really interested one, especially in science. You can find this article, the Human Genome Project, especially few diseases are more ethnical one. So that means the human biodiversity is also most important in the in terms of health conditions. And then economic. So ecological economics, I think one of these webinars produced by an economic lawyer, something I saw one word. So ecological economics of biodiversity. And how this ecosystem is changing the, what's it, alleviating the poverty in a particular ecosystems, especially mountains ecosystem, how these people, they are earning and then their ecological economical status, their life quality, and trades off and governments. And not only this, and how much cost we need, economics of biodiversity conservations, how the developed nations they are spending, how these European countries and then how Asian countries they are spending for this. The last two part of this, health sectors, or health level, how this biodiversity can conservations. And this biodiversity is sustainable relationship with human health. Okay, so especially the biodiversity changes affects this human health. Even this present COVID also, it's another thing, a new viral biodiversity. It's still now it's a big enigma, because in USA right now it's a summer, whereas in Brazil it's winter, but this virus is active. So how this viral biodiversity is affecting the human health, it's that's also a big concept. And then the biomedicines which are produced by diverse biodiversity components, that's also a real excellent field that youngsters, young students who are attending in this webinar, you can think about your career, you can go for some internship, people who are working in this. And then one thing I want to tell after finishing this PowerPoint, I will mention my email ID. Anyone wants to have this PowerPoint to develop further, I am ready to send by email without hiding anything. Fantastic. So a lot of pharmaceuticals and agrochemical industries from this biodiversity are also is coming up. It's well studied. And then philosophy of biodiversity. And then biodivinity. So people, they are related with religions, especially India and all. We are always thinking what is the linking with religions, especially when the locust comes, all the Christians started telling it's already mentioned in Bible, blah 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 blah, like that. So we are more emotional and sentimental, always linking with religious stuffs, biodivinity and biodiversity, lot of religious environmentalism. And this is about the 7 levels, but I want to discuss few updates, recent updates about Indian biodiversity. And India still, this biodiversity lists are not finished. Still we are finding new species, especially Gujarati, Assam. So far they found 334 species. Fantastic new species they listed out, they found. And then this Andhra Pradesh, they have cheered up this tiger numbers increase by the conservation methodology. And after 129 years, Assam conservation scientists, they found this keelback spotted snake after 129 years. So that means these people are still hiding in things, and we need to find conservation scientists with the help of taxonomists or biologists. They have to find, re-identify our new identification. They have to do that. Okay. Then in recently they found this this brown fish owl in Nilgiris. They found this. And this Malabar gliding, it jumps even up to 12 meter height. Found in Kerala and Gulf of Mannar. The beginning of our webinar, they posted this video file. I saw this Gulf of Mannar. A rare scorpion fish, they recently invented in Kochi. Gulf of Mannar. Then this is also most important. Just a 7 centimeter fish in Kerala they found in Belangani. It's called a silver fish. So that means in Indian biodiversity, still lot to investigate, lot to find, lot to invent. Still this biodiversity composition is not completed. Still we are enriched with the fauna and flora. So this biodiversity, if you keenly notice this biodiversity, you will understand this biodiversity is orderly nature one. It's not random, orderly nature linked with each other. So that means their function in the ecology is most important. It links with others' functions also. Orderly nature linked with each other, these two things. So simply saying they are linked with each other. If one chain is cut off, then the entire ecosystem will suffer. So biodiversity is most important one. So conservation is also important one. And last few years, people started crying for this biodiversity is under threat. So much of threats, either by natural calamities or by human exploitation or anthropogenic atrocities, I can say. So for natural things, few examples I am discussing. The recent storm, Amban. Okay, so this storm, especially in Assam, this national park was totally affected. You can see a tiger is swimming. So that means a threat to biodiversity, either by nature or by human. We are discussing few natural things. And even today's Hindu newspaper in magazine page number 1, you can find this. In Australia, due to this bushfires, especially during 2019 to 2020, since last year to recent one, 3 billion animals were affected. They were totally displaced. So much of biodiversity problem in Australia by this bushfire, a natural calamity. And then man-made, this I don't want to discuss in deep in webinar. So in this actor's house, they found this ivory in his house, then they later released. So coming to ivory again in Kuala Lumpur, recently they found 24 tons of tusks. Just imagine 24 tons for ivory ornaments. See, especially in Sri Lanka, if you go to Sri Lanka, these temples and all, I'm not discussing about any particular religious. We are intellectual biologists, so frankly, openly, I'm discussing so that in a way you can create awareness to these people. Okay. So one piece of this trunk is 12 kilogram. So for 24 kg. So 24 ton means, just imagine how many elephants, minimum 1,000 elephants they would have killed, 24 tons. And nowadays you can see in wherever these things, and this elephant was poisoned. Okay, so we need to have a strict, very strict environmental laws. That is most important for biodiversity conservation. Especially an elephant, it must walk for 18 kilometers per day. But throughout India, many temples, many places, they are domesticated. You can see it's always tied up with chain. Not only in Kerala, in Bihar. At the front, you can see a lot of ornaments. But at the back, they are tied with chains. When you look into closer, chain, and then skin decoloration. You can see these images, how this elephant or under stress. So this man is having apple for to tolerate the sunlight, whereas this elephant. Lot of cracks. So much of elephant deaths in India. Recently, I think no need to discuss that. And then in July 2nd, in Botswana, Southern Africa, at a time they found 350 elephants found dead in Botswana. And this death, till now they are not able to dissect what could be the reason. It's a mystery. So maybe due to anthrax, but the tusks are very intact. So still a lot to do, they have to do. But on the same day in our Tamil Nadu, one man, Mettupalayam man, he shot an elephant. Very easily he killed an elephant with a gun. Not only elephants, this one horn rhinos are illegally trade off to China. All this horn, these Chinese, they have a lot of traditional medicines. They have a superstitious thinking that when they use this one horn and all in the medicines, the men will become more super powerful man. A lot of stupidity and superstitious. So for this, they are killing this animal, one horned, in Kaziranga National Park. It happened. Poachers. And even during lockdown time, they caught these three hunters in Assam. So they killed these rhinos. So not only elephant and rhino, tigers also, they are trade off to China. In China, 1 kg of tiger meat is 15 lakhs. Just imagine, one tiger is around 360 kilograms. So how much money? 54 crores. But for this money, they are killing this tiger and trade off to China. So automatically our population is reduced. I think this is our conservation scientists, they are having very good strict norms. Right now they are controlling it. So not only meat, the skin also, not only in, even in Tamil Nadu, this information I got it. So if you visit WWF, you can understand why you should save the tigers. The tigers are top of these food chains, in ecological food chains. So tigers' presence are most important for efficient ecological functions. Fantastic. Even during lockdown, again, these poachers, they killed a lot of these deers. And not only this hunting, due to some inbreeding technologies, so especially this forced abortion, infanticides in this domesticated one in zoos and sanctuaries. So these fragments the habitats of these rare monkeys. So these are the reasons. So this biodiversity is still under threats. And anthropogenic, it's religious, as I said earlier. So during this festival, they are dissolving a giant-sized statues. And people, they started using lot of nickel paints, silver paints. And these paints are going to the ocean, not only in Chennai, in Mumbai also, big, big size. Not only Chennai, Mumbai, also in Calcutta, they are having this festival. So if you keenly watch during September and October time in these three spots, Calcutta, Chennai and Mumbai, so they are dissolving these huge statues with a lot of chemical paints. So what happened during at the time, these giant animals, sea creatures, so due to climate change, extreme winter in those areas, they are coming to these oceans. When they enter into Indian oceans, they started dying. And there are two major reasons for this. They are very sensitive to these chemicals and all chemical paints, and then microplastics in this ocean. So these two reasons you can see. So in January, February, March, every year I have collection of more than 10 years. Every year, these 3 months, January, February, March, you can find these ocean creatures are dying in our Indian Ocean. Dolphins, and then 800 turtles at a time in Nellore. Not only in Nellore, in here also, in Chennai also, turtles, 130 turtles. Yes. So when there is no human interferences, wild animals started appearing. So this itself is a very good evidence that so anthropogenic interferences affecting the biodiversity conservation. So there is a dire need of conservation. Okay. So there are two kinds of conservation, as you all know, that is ex situ conservation, as a whole, making a habitat and then conserving the things. In India, there are 10 species are listed in endangered species. Then, say for example, in tiger, for tiger, we have a lot of tiger reserves in India. The popular one is Mudumalai Tiger Reserves, and our founder, Dr. Kumaragavu, is having few research articles from this Mudumalai Tiger Reserve. So by ex situ conservation, making a habitat for this endangered species and then protecting them and then breeding them. This is also conservation. Whereas in one horn rhino, Kaziranga Park, in National Park in Assam. So whereas in situ conservation, here only biotechnology is coming. What is in situ conservation? Conservation of genetic resources in natural population of plant or animal species, such as forest genetic resources in natural populations of tree species. So recently people started thinking about genome level conservation, biodiversity and evolution. Plant genome. This book is a really excellent book. If you have time, please download the book and go through that. So in addition to these 7 levels what we discussed earlier, which are the traditional levels, a new level that is called as gene level or genome level, they are studying the biodiversity conservation, and they are started establishing few methods. Okay. As I said earlier, there are 2 methods, but the second method I am not going to discuss, that is the transgenic method, which is more debateful in Indian context. So in order to avoid the illegal traits, so far we studied the in conservation, we studied only the morphological parameters. So with advanced technologies, so they started studying the DNA barcoding. For example, this flowchart, you can see this. So you can collect samples. These samples can be anything. It can be protist, or it can be elephant, or it can be tiger, anything, anything. Butterfly, mosquitoes. So collect the samples, representative samples, and then extract DNA. This is more critical method, especially if biology people, they know very well. Each organisms, we need to optimize the DNA extraction method, because this NaOH, sodium hydroxide precipitation itself, it varies. And then this, ethanol wash steps are varying. So DNA extraction method. After successfully extracting, you have to check the purity of the DNA of what you isolated from the samples. So this extracted DNA must be free of impurities. And then that sufficient material, not sufficient for sequencing. So you have to amplify this PCR amplification. So here only the real DNA barcoding comes. So you have to select some of the marker genes. So I will discuss a little later about the marker genes. So after amplification, you have to sequence it. Then once you sequence, you know the species identification for each species in a genera. There's little changes in this homology sequences, then you can have this bioinformatics setups. So this is the sequencing. So for amplification, there are few primers, 16S primers, XTNS primer, 18S primer, ITS1, ITS2, that is internal transcribed spacer elements. So you can design primers in these regions. If you are familiar with PCR, in mitochondria, one enzyme called cytochrome oxidase 1. This enzyme is right now more well used in this DNA barcoding, because in the bottom, if you compare the number of copies, enormous amount of cytochrome oxidase enzymes are present. These genes are present. So among these five primers, almost 90% of the people, they are using the cytochrome oxidase 1 gene for DNA barcoding. So I am repeatedly telling, DNA barcoding is a recent biotechnological tool to identify the species. So once you identify the species, then illegal trade-off cannot be done. Suppose from Assam to Assam border to China, they are illegally transporting this one horn rhino. Then if you know the sequence, just take a few samples, quickly test it, and then you can go for legal things. So this is the DNA barcoding for this Google Meet. So I am going to discuss only few samples. Okay. So the first few examples I am going to discuss. First example, Professor Ghosh from Assam University, Department of Biotechnology. So Assam College, in collaboration with College of Veterinary Science and then West Bengal Animal and Physical Sciences. So Assam University, in collaboration with two more institutes. So all the participants, we should realize that collaborations are most important for such studies, because DNA isolation kit, PCR machine, PCR kits, and reproducibility of results and bioinformatics tools, which involves huge money, very huge money. So we are in collaboration, we can share these financial burdens and we can come up with successfully. There are so much of plants and animals were DNA barcoded. But for this webinar, I am discussing only five examples. This is the first example. Professor Ghosh from Assam University, in collaboration with Veterinary Science College and Animal and Fishery Science University, West Bengal. So they sequenced, they DNA barcoded this Royal Bengal tiger, and they compared in parallel domestic cat, Indian domestic cat, two things. They published this paper in Journal of Environment and Sociobiology, okay, in 2013, 7 years ago. And in this paper, so the great success of this paper is, after DNA barcoding, they deposited in gene bank. If you Google gene bank, you can find this gene bank. And this is the sequence they deposited for Royal Tiger, Bengal Royal Tiger. DNA barcoding. And then this is the sequence. Once you know the sequence, nucleic acid sequence, the protein sequence also very easy. Cytochrome C oxidase subunit number 1. So this is the protein sequencing. This is the nucleic acid sequence. And for common cat also, domesticated Indian cat also, they deposited this same enzyme. And this is the nucleic acid sequence, DNA sequence. This is the protein sequence. Once you know the nucleic acid sequence, it is with the help of bioinformatics tool, you can easily deduce the protein sequences. Coming to the second example, it's about ornamental fishes barcoding, DNA barcoding. And again, Calcutta scientists, so they performed this DNA barcoding and deposited the first fish is Barna fish in Murthy River. The second half snakehead fish, and they isolated DNA from these two, and the same enzyme, that is cytochrome C oxidase, subunit number one. I said the reason, the copies are more, so performance is very easy. Then sequencing is also very easy. Then the third example, butterfly, Nymphalidae families. So the scientists from University of Pune, so these scientists, they barcoded, DNA barcoded butterflies of a family called Nymphalidae. Okay, so they collected these species from Western Ghats, entire Western Ghats. It's really a par excellent paper. If you are really interested, if you email me, I will send the link. So they barcoded, and then they came with each species of this Nymphalidae, and then they came with the divergence percentage. So that means they completely mapped this butterfly gene barcoding, DNA barcoding. And the fourth example is, so this parasite is called as elephant stomach parasite. This parasite is very, very dangerous. It starts laying eggs near the mouth of elephants. Later, these larvae, they go inside the stomach. At one point, what will happen? This is called a stomach butterfly species in Asian elephants. At one point, parasitic infection is very high, then the elephant will die. So this is a very serious problem in elephants, especially in Asian elephants. So scientists, very recent paper, April 2020, a team of scientists, they discovered that they took that insect DNA, and then they checked with African elephants and Asian elephants. They found lot of matches, and they came with genome DNA barcoding, they came with gene accession numbers, and they deposited in gene bank. Coming to the last example, our own example from our founder, this BCF founder, Dr. Kumaragava. He published an excellent paper, and they have done DNA analysis in Bengal Royal Tiger. Okay, an excellent study along with B. Ramakrishnan. So cannibalism in Royal Bengal Tiger. So they collected this cannibalism nature using the DNA analysis. I tried to download this paper, but unable to find it. I think if he is available, we can discuss during the discussion time. So coming to the conclusion, so what I said is just a seed information, as I said earlier. So you need to develop into a big tree. Okay. So simply saying, our biodiversity is our future. So we need to take care of our biodiversity. At least our level, we need awareness. So we need to care all these organisms. And especially, they are innocent creatures. We need to consider them, protect them, create awareness. And this picture I like very much. During this storm, your mother is protecting her son. A motherly care, a motherly love, we should show on biodiversity. So for this, we need combined and collaborations of many things, competence, knowledge, learning, experience, and lot more. So thank you so much. This is my email ID. If you want, I can send this PowerPoint to you. Thank you so much.